Guys, we're hanging out here at Bonnaroo. It's 2019. This is our fifth year covering Bonnaroo here, this time on The Spectrum and Sirius XMU and Alt Nation. I'm Julia Cunningham, and we're joined by Clementine from the band Cherry Glazer.
Thanks for having me.
Oh my gosh, please, thank you for coming by. I mean, I know, I saw that you tweeted that you guys have already performed 70 shows in 2019, and we're just in June, and you're adding another one in with your stop here at Bonnaroo. But this is your first Roo.
Yeah, it's our first Roo. It's been great so far. We love this fest.
Well, and you know what? You actually have a year where it's not at 100 degrees by like noon.
Oh, I know. It's so perfect. It's beautiful. It's like breezy and like high 70s. It's like
it's amazing. Like a doll today. Yeah. I do want to know though, like, had you heard sort of about, because obviously bands that we sort of feature on Sirius XMU and Cherry Glazer in particular, like, seem like road heavy bands that would have known all the festivals. I know you guys still have a lot of festivals this summer, but
we
like
do.
What did you heard about Bonnaroo? Has that been one that you've wanted to play?
It has been. I heard so many great things about this fest in a way that you don't really hear about other festivals, that it's like open and creative and cool, and the space is so cool, and all of those things are true.
Yeah, and I don't know if you'll have actual time to get around, but it's worthy of just popping out into the camping area just
to
see it.
I'm so excited to do that. We passed a slip and slide on the way here.
It's wild.
And I was blown away.
It's pretty crazy.
I cannot wait to get on that. And I just got a new bathing suit, so
oh my God, throw it on and rip through that camping situation. I want to talk to you about the album, which obviously is going to be prominently heard when you guys go up on stage.
Mm-hmm.
Stuffed and Ready was released back in February, so you've had it under your belt, obviously, for some time performing it live. Like, does it already feel like a lot of those songs sit differently with you now, having just like time between you and writing?
You know, the way I think of it is like I write the songs for myself and I perform them for others.
Mm-hmm.
And that's true. That becomes a little more true the more you play them. I think always what's most fun is the thing that you've written the most recently. But the album still feels really fresh, and to see it connect with people is really amazing, and it blows me away, and I just feel very, very lucky to be able to play stages.
Yeah, I remember when you joined us just earlier this year for a session, and you were chatting with our very own Jenny Eliscu, and you were talking about how there was something though about this sort of batch of songs where your voice really stepped forward, and you feel now like getting this out like in a cathartic sense, like that you're still writing even though you just have an album out, like you're sort of in that zone of and you're in a weird way, like your voice is popping, your style of writing is popping or something.
I do. I feel like I've come into my own and found my sound a little bit more than I had before. A lot in part to having a lot of great supporters, my bandmates and my team and my friends and family. I think as you get older, you just kind of are able to articulate yourself better. And I feel really grateful that I am able to articulate myself and put that into song and words.
Yeah, the song Daddy in particular is a true banger of a tune, although, you know, you can hear it in different realms, I guess, right? You can either really focus in on those lyrics and be like, oh, damn, or you can just sort of hear the melody of it and be like, wow, this is undeniably a bop. And is that one that really stands out when you're playing live? Does the audience really react to that?
I love playing that one live. And the audience has been reacting to it. It's been crazy. They've been going crazy for that one. So that's been cool.
Yeah.
I know this might not be very like songwriterly of me to say, but I think melody is more important than anything else. And I've always had sort of a keen sense of it. And I love counter melodies, like a melody and a counter melody. I don't love a lot of like harmonization, but having two main melodies that work well together, it just makes gives me tingles.
So now, do you keep like a notes page in your phone where you're sort of humming out melodies to yourself if you're catching something?
I do on my, exactly. I just was doing that in the van.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that sort of your project? Like, will you go back later and then be like, okay, let me just see if I can put words to this, but
yes,
more focusing, let me find the melody first.
Yeah, exactly.
That's interesting.
That's how I write. Melodies pop into my head. I record them and then I translate them onto the guitar or synth or bass, and then goes from there.
Are you guys a band that will work out material live ever? Like, is there ever a time where you're like, I really think we have a song. I know we're just on tour right now. Should we try it? Or is that kind of a scary thing for an artist?
That's scary and that's fun. We've done that before. We just opened for churches and we decided to add this song Pieces from Stuffed and Ready, and we'd never played it before, and we just threw it in the set and started playing it, and it was really fun and nerve-wracking because it's a tricky little guitar part, and I think I'm pretty sure I messed it up at one of the shows, but it's okay.
You know what? You've got like probably 100 more shows coming that you can always work it out. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for spending time with us.
Thanks
here
so much for having
out.
Me. It was really fun.
No, it's been lovely to actually chat with you, and we're super excited to be airing your set on SiriusXMU as well, so thank you for that.